Welcome back. Esther is a former teacher. I say former because she was teacher only until the COVID-19 pandemic forced her to think harder of where she would go when the schools closed. The gold mine was right below her feet, but maybe a little push would help her find it. Darren paid a visit to Esther, and now they tell the story of how she managed to make it through the COVID-19 pandemic, which has ravaged the country for 2 years now.
When a door closes, it doesn't mean another door won't open, especially if you take time to explore yourself and find an opportunity. Esther was a nursery teacher, but we all know that when the pandemic happened, there was a lockdown and all schools closed. The first lifting of the lockdown only accepted primary students and also some secondary students to go back to school. Nursery schools still remained closed. What happened next? Esther adventured and learned how to do some handcrafts, and that's how she has managed to survive from January last year to today. But let's talk to Esther and find out how she picked interest in crafts and how she's faring at the moment.
My name is Nakato Esther Nambiro, and I am a professional teacher, and apparently I am doing much of art and craft work. That is what I am doing now. I have been a teacher since 2017. I think those are 4 years now I've been a teacher, and I've been so much in ECD, that is early childhood development, or nursery section, mostly known as that, and that's the level I have been teaching. I started dealing with children ever since I think I was 12 years. I was dealing with the children, and at the same time I was doing art and craft. I love both of the two. I love the two things because I was apparently, when I was still young, I used to teach in Sunday schools. I started with, when they were calling me Auntie Esther in the Sunday schools. And when I was growing, I always wanted to be around the children. And at the same time, I loved doing art and craft. So before, I was just doing art as something, hobby or my other side work. But when this came in, the COVID-19, I had to resort to this, since everyone is at home and they are seeing that, oh, I don't have a doormat. And I said, I have to be in this match, since the schools have been closed down for now 2 years. At first, when they had just closed down, I sat down and, you know, there's something they tell you and you don't believe. I thought actually schools would resume in 1 to 2 months. That's what I was expecting. But after sitting for about, I think, 5 months, I said, Esther, you know what? You used to do art and crafts. Why don't you go back to that? So I started now getting new ideas, doing this, doing that. Actually, I didn't know how to do the bottles, these ones, the bottle deco. I didn't know how to do them. I said, Esther, you know what? You need to do something out of this. You don't need to look at COVID-19 as something that is going to shatter you down, because you have a lot in your mind that you have not yet received. So I had actually one bottle. I had to start doing the bottles. I tried out the ceramic work. I tried out the different new ideas. The ideas I had of art and craft were a little bit not so much on the market. They were not so modern. So when I sat down after the teaching, I said, as I'm waiting for the schools to be opened, because 2020, everyone thought 2021 schools would open again. So everyone was, let's wait for 2021. As for me, I had to tell myself, find out new ideas. Because despite the fact that COVID had come, the landlord was not going to stop asking for money. the stomach was not going to stop asking for food. So we had to resort to different ways. So I had to get modern ideas of art and craft. I realized people love decorating the homes, dotto deco, the doormats, the shoes. Ideas started coming just slowly by slowly. And before I knew it, within 2 months, I had a lot that I had brought on the table. Where did I get the capital and how much? First, I'll go to how much, probably. I remember the first thing I started with, it was trying out the flower pots, the vases, those ceramic ones. I remember I had 5,000. I had lunch on that money and I had gotten a new idea. So I said, I think for today I'll skip lunch and first focus on this idea. When I bought the ceramic work, it was for 3,500. I think the cement, I think that's the cost. Yeah, 3,500. Because the idea I wanted, it was not mixing a lot. It was only cement. And I remained with 1,500. I remember I ate that for my supper. But I was focused to first invent this. When I did my first work and posted it, everyone liked it. It was immediately bought at 10,000. I started with the ceramic work, which is pottery, or doing the flower pots.
Oh, flower pots.
Yes.
You designed a flower pot.
I designed a flower pot. But the reason as to why I didn't continue with the flower pots was because the cement was burning my fingers, and I did have it in mind that I could buy gloves. So I said, let me do something different. And when I did the bottles, my first bottle was bought at 20,000. When it was bought at 20,000 and I looked at how much I had put in the bottle and how much I had put in the ceramic work, I said, let me resort to now the bottles. I left the other one and I went with the bottles. So each day I was getting money to make me go to bigger dreams. Like after the bottle, I found myself, I said, okay, I've gotten the 20. How much had you put in the bottle? I had put 2,000 in the bottle, almost all together. So I said, okay, if I have 20,000, it can take me to Domas. So that is how I started doing this. And capital, and how I got it, I had 5,000, which was for lunch and supper, but I had to deduct the lunch, eat supper, and then get a new idea. How big I am. I'm bigger than the 20,000. I'm bigger than the 3,500. I'm bigger than the 10,000. Apparently, when I sit down and know everything that I have, I go in 1M plus. When I sit down, calculate everything, besides the capital I'm putting in, the profits, I'm in 1M plus. Which is, you know, when we were working as teachers, one thing I have realized about us, the teachers in Uganda, it is so unfortunate. We teachers, we are underpaid. We do a lot because we are the ones who are teaching presidents. But when you see, you cannot tell me a teacher comes in the morning, 6:30, teaches, and at the end of the month, the teacher is getting 300 when the school is getting 300. Meaning a teacher is working for 10,000 a day. And here I am, Esther. In a day, I have to ensure that every hour, at least I get 50,000. Every hour. I have to ensure that I have made 50,000 in an hour. If I am seated, concentrated, that I'm doing everything, I can get 5M in a day if I'm doing my art and craft work. What I can tell to my fellow teachers, you know, quitting is good. and sometimes it is bad. If you know that you can still do this, and now because now me, I thank God that I can do the art and craft work, I can do the tailoring, and I can still get what to eat. But there are those teachers that know that without teaching, I am no more. So to those teachers, I pray that you continue with the heart, continue with the passion. Don't teach because you have a salary or an amount of fee attached to what you're doing. Because when I was in teaching, despite the money they were giving me, I always loved the children. You know, some teachers have a heart, they're giving us small money, like, you know, and then they put all the blame to the kids. It is not the children. Teach with passion. To the teachers who are saying that they're not going back, ensure you have found yourself well. Like, you have now known what you can do. Not to just jump into things just because you're seeing Esther is doing it. No. Do something knowing that it is taking you somewhere. It is building you. It is building your tomorrow. Not only I am getting food for the day. We are not working for the food for the day. Let us stop that mentality. Teachers, you should know that what I am doing is building me tomorrow, is building me the other day and the other day. Now when I'm going to do these photos, because here personally I'm always busy, I have kids that come around. You know that children are not learning. So they come around, I have 5 or 6. They always collect these bottles for me, and when they come with the many bottles, I buy their bottles. I give them the money and I get the bottles. I also use wood glue. Wood glue, I buy it from the hardware or the stationery, and then also the threads. Threads, I use the small threads which people know that, okay, they use them for plaiting the hair, but I also use the other ones for large hooked mats. So I use these two when I am doing my bottles, and I buy these ones from the shops, but mainly I get them from town. I use the wide bottles, as you can see now. I don't take wide, but I use the wide bottles. I buy them, and I also have the soda bottles. There are some bottles like for Coca-Cola, they are good. Not the Fanta, those ones are a bit disturbing, but mainly I use the biggest capacity, I'm using the wine bottles. Then I have here, these are called pipe wall hangings. When I'm making these pipe wall hangings, I need a pipe which is like this. It can be in a different sizes. So this one is medium and this is the smallest. So I get the pipe, I have the pipe, still I use the threads and also the wood glue. But then I also use hot glue. It's not here with me, but I use hot glue when I am making my base.
Where do you get those pipes?
I get these pipes I buy them from the hardware shops. Yes, and then the threads still in town and the nearby shops. I do my marketing. One, I personally love crafts, so when I'm dressing up, most cases I dress up crafts. On my head, I'll put on a beret, I'll put on a poncho, I'll put on socks, I'll put on gloves, and when I'm moving, people will ask me, where did you buy the beret? Those who are interested, where did you get the beret or the poncho you're putting on? So when they ask me something like that, I'll tell them, oh, I make them myself. Meaning I have already gotten a market. Then two, I always do via social media, because we know that the world we are living in is we are now in the world of, you know, you have to be with a smartphone. When I put my work on my WhatsApp status, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you will get people, clients. And then also, when I sell my work to someone, you know, I always ensure that I sell quality so that someone else will ask, where did you buy that? So that they can come back to me, that market. So when you do something good, if you do something just for this person has asked, let me just do and I give, trust me, you'll not get market again. But if you do something with all your heart, you're going to get market more and more. People are going to be coming to you inquiring, how did you do this? This one wants this. Can you do this? And me, one thing I know, I can do everything. So long as it is concerning art and craft, I can do it. And that is how I do my marketing.
Financial advisors have always talked to employers or employees that whereas you're working, you need more 7 streams of income to make an extra living. And I hope that Esther's story has taught you something, that whereas she's a professional teacher, she can still make money out of crafts. Find time and learn a skill so you can earn an extra living. My name is Darren Bartlett on Making Money.
Well, from Esther's story, I now believe that most things in life can be learned, and once perfected, can be tilted into our own favor. I hope that you get something that can save you from the COVID-19 pandemic crisis in the pocket. Time now for the personal finance segment, and this week we look at customer care, but also how to make sure that you perfect the art of customer care, which plays a center role in the success of your business.
What is good customer service? Good customer service is the quality and timely assistance provided by a business and its employees to the people who use or buy its products and services. Customer service can range from aiding customers with purchases to solving their problems online. Here are ways to provide great customer service. 1. Be friendly. The most important rule in providing excellent customer service is to be friendly. Try to greet customers with a smile, always be courteous and respectful. It is important to always remain kind, even through stressful situations. 2. Respond promptly. Customer service involves the timeliness of your responses. Customers appreciate a quick response, especially when they have a time-sensitive request. Try to return all phone calls and emails within 24 hours and let customers know how long it will take you to assist them. 3. Know your product or service. To offer your customers excellent service, you should know every aspect of the product or service you are selling. 4. Listen to your customers. Listening is one of the simplest ways to provide excellent customer service. Sometimes customers just need to be heard, so be sure to actively listen to what they have to say. They might have a point that you can use to make your product or service even better. 5. Say thank you. Customers often remember sincere gratitude, and it reminds them why they hired your company or shopped at your store. Saying thank you after every transaction is an easy way to provide excellent customer service. 6. Get to know your customer. Providing great customer service means knowing who your customers are and what they want. When you have a better understanding of your customers and what drives them, you will find it easier to offer them the personalized customer service they need.
With good customer care, as you realize, you're halfway the job of keeping all your customers and actually getting more. Now let's take a look at this week's Forex and money market reports. Thank you. that does it for this week's edition of The Business Show. Thank you very much for making time to watch tonight. We do hope you can catch all our episodes on our YouTube channel, and there is a hashtag The Business Show that's on Urban TV Uganda and on all our social media platforms. Also, make sure that you catch every single segment in person to be able to learn how to make money, learn what the authorities are saying, that is from the views from the top, and also learn how to make sure that your money goes to places you know and not waking up and wondering what happened to my money. That's in personal finance tips. Thank you very much. My name is Viola. I'll see you next time. Always 10 p.m. Thursdays every week. Until then, good night.